वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं यो वेदाग्निश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तहुमहदेवमात्मोति प्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्येऽहं। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So we begin the Tritiya Taranga, and in Tritiya Taranga, Guru Lakshana is being described. Continuing with that, so Bhaya Hetu. It was said that Bhaya Hetu, the Dvaita becomes Bhaya Hetu. And Pramana quoted was Udaram Antaram Kurute Dvitiya Dvai Bhayam Bhavati Ityadi Shruti Bhyaha Tasmad Bhedo Avashyam Khandaniya. One should give up Bheda and land on Advaita, Abheda. So Taittiriya Upanishad said Udaram Antaram Kurute. So there will be Bhaya due to that. What? Ut Aram Antaram Kurute, one who makes even a little aram, little difference, even a little bheda lingers on, then that will lead to samsara continuing because bhaya will continue. Dvitiyadvai bhayam bhavati. Due to another, there is fear. So even when one is alone, it is not the fear of being alone, but it is the fear of someone other than me being there who may harm me. Thereby, Shruti says, Dvitiyadvai bhayam bhavati, tasmad bhedaha avashyam khandaniyaha. Ukta lakshana eva acharya swasishyam avidyadi sarvamula shunya advitiya brahma eva ahamasmi iti sakshad aparokshanubhava vantam kartum shaknuyat. One who himself has advaita jnana, has sakshatkara, and also knows the methodology of teaching the Advaita Tattva, which can be very difficult to understand. And that being the Tatparya of the Shruti is also difficult to show. Therefore, one who is Ukta Lakshana Acharya, that kind of person alone, can Swashishyam Avidyadi Sarvam Malashunya अद्वितीय ब्रह्मेव अहमस्मि इति साक्षात् अपरोक्षानुभवंतम कर्तुम शक्नु. सो लाइक हिमसेल्फ ही कैन मेक दी अदर आल्सो रियलाइज दिस अद्वितीय ब्रह्म विच इज फ्री फ्रॉम अविद्या एटसेट्रा अविद्यादि अविद्या काम कर्म जनरल ट्रायड वी टेक अविद्या काम कर्म सर्व मल शून्यम ऑल दीज आर मलास एंड दोज मलास आरंट देयर इन दिस ब्रह्म बिकॉज there is nothing other than from it as well. So Advitiya Brahma, that Brahma I am. When Guru teaches that, even the Shishya understands that he is that Guru. Like the Guru also, he is realized now. And he also can say that Advitiya Brahma, which is Avidyadi Sarvamala Shunya, that kind of Advitiya Brahma, Eva Ahamasmi. Iti Sakshad Aparokshanubhavantam Kartum Shaknuyat. He will also become Aparoksha Anubhavan. Meaning, here it is said in a causative sense because the teacher, the guru shifts the vritti that the guru has द सेम वृत्ति शुड टेक प्लेस इन द शिष्याज माइंड इवन इन वेदिक चैंटिंग द चैंटिंग इज टीचिंग इज सच दैट वॉट एवर इज इन दी द वृत्ति इन द अंतकरण ऑफ द गुरु दैट टेक्स प्लेस इन द अंतकरण ऑफ द शिष्य सो इट इज दैट यू नो इन मॉडर्न लैंग्वेज ट्रांसफर ऑफ नॉलेज यू नो नॉलेज ट्रांसफर और यू नो the way you say TOT, technology transfer, transfer of technology, but you know, they say KT, knowledge transfer. So what is really that knowledge transfer really is the same vritti that takes place in the mind of the acharya should take place in the mind of the shishya. That's why the teaching continues till it is said avagati paryantam jnanam. Till it is realized, Brahma is known as one's own swarupa, till then the teaching continues. साक्षात् अपरोक्षानुभवन्तं कर्तुं शक्नुयात् आचार्य उक्तलक्षणैव cannot be anyone else who is trained in the sampradaya and not only that he also should have sakshatkara tadrsh sakshatkaravan eva shishyah and then once he also gets the shishya also gets that sakshatkara then he is really the shishya in the true sense of the word because shishya means shasana yogyah shishyah One who can be taught. Not everyone can be taught. People who think that everyone can be taught and start teaching everyone, they learn the mistake sooner than later. That's why adhikaritvam is described in the Shastra. Otherwise, if the crowd itself is mixed of adhikaris and non-adhikaris, complete non-adhikaris, there can be gradations of adhikara. There definitely are gradations in jnanis. There are gradations in shishya. Undoubtedly. However, there should be adhikaritvam as described in the Shastra. Just because, you know someone or, you know, someone is closely connected to the, to someone you know, or just because, you know, someone is funding, these do not become adhikaris. Adhikaritvam has to be as per the Shastra. One can have one's own definition and do it, but then unfortunately the teaching sampradaya does not continue. The others who are adhikaris won't get it because the class has to be completely diluted so that the bottom of the class gets it. Then even the earlier misses out. So it is not going to benefit anyone. That's why shasana yogya shishyaha. Or shasana shishya also, but shasana yogya. This year here is in the year pratyaya in the sense of yogyata. Sarvopi samsara drishya prapanchaha advaitaha swapnadivan mayi chinmatre swajnana vashad mithya pratibhasate iti saksha janiya. Then this shishya who has been taught because of his adhikara also and because of the Guru also being qualified, sarva api samsara drishya prapanchaha. This drishya prapancha dvaitaha swapnadivat mithya. Swapnavat mithya. Swapnadivat adipadena rajju sarpa you can take. This dvaita prapancha is swajnana vashat. Under the influence of one's own ajnana, it is mithya and pratibhasate chinmatre pratibhasate in My real swarupa, which is chinmatra, in me, it appears. There is a pratiti matra. Swapnavat, rajju sarpavat, therefore, mithya. And further, we will say drishyatvat mithya. Dvaitis say drishyatvat satyam. We say drishyatvat mithya, same hetu, works differently. They say that because it is seen, it is real. If it is so, then Swapna should be real. Rajju Sarpa should be real. They say, yes, it is real. They say it is real, it is elsewhere. So, it is very difficult to argue where logic does not work. Therefore, Bhagavan Gaudapada Acharya, Mandukya Karikara, he had to establish that Swapna is Mithya. Here we just use it Swapna Divat. But Swapna being Mithya has to be established when he is talking to Dvaitins. They think that Swapna is real. So he argues and establishes even for these who say that Swapna is real, he has to show that Swapna cannot be real, Swapna is unreal. He has to say, Uchita Desha Kala Abhavat. Hetu there is, Uchita Desha is not there, Uchita Kala is not there. The waker does not find himself in the same place that he was dreaming. All this has to be established, unfortunately. Because if you conclude without using logic, which connects back to the Shruti, then logic can work either way. But even with pure logic, they have gone wrong. How can anyone say that Swapna is real? Anyway, that aside, Swapnadivat Mai Chinmatre Swajnana Vashan Mithya Pratibhasate Iti Sakshat Janiyat Kasa Shishyaha Sakshat Karvan Bhavati. Idrisha Adbhuta Dudarsha Swatma Tattvopadeshta Eva Acharyaha Iti Uchyate. And one who can get this Sakshatkara to the Shishya. Tracing back, you know, did this Shishya benefit? Then, Idrisha Adbhuta Dudarsha Swatma Tattvopadeshta, one who can explain the inexplicable. That which cannot be known through words, that cannot be objectified through the Indriyas and Antakkarana also, which is so subtle, subtler than the subtlest, that is Adbhuta, it is a wonder. Shruti says it is Adbhuta. The Acharya is Adbhuta, the subject matter is Adbhuta, the Shishya who understands is Adbhuta. It's all a wonder. How can something which cannot be explained in words is explained by the Shruti? Look at the Mahima of Shruti. How can that be understood and how can it be taught? So, everything and everyone involved in that is a wonder. It is also a wonder as to how we missed it after Sakshatkara. It is also a wonder as to how we missed something which cannot be missed, which is your own Swarupa. So the Shishya who has Sakshatkara, he thinks, how did I miss it? It is my own Swarupa. So clear as day to me now. And I cannot even understand how did I miss it. And when that Shishya becomes an Acharya to teach, he can explain only because there is Sampradaya backing how to teach. Otherwise, what he finds difficult to miss now, now that I know my own Swarupa, I wonder how I missed it earlier, how will I teach it? The only way to teach it is the way it is taught in the Sampradaya by the Neti Neti Prakriya. So, Keno Upanishad Acharya says, we do not know how to teach. We don't know how to teach at all other than what has been taught by our Acharyas. So, Idrisha Adbhuta Dudarsha. Dudarsha, very difficult. Dukhena, Darsha here is, Du is in the sense of, Dur is in the sense of Dukha, Dukhena. So, Idrisha Adbhuta Dukhena Darsha Swatma Tattvopadeshta Eva Acharya Iti Uchyate. Samsara Mahagraha Grastam Shishyam Tan Mukhat Jiva Brahmadvaito Padeshena Yo Mochayati Saeva Guruhu. So in the real sense, who is the Guru who has been able to free the Shishya from the Samsara Mahagraha Grasa? From the grasp of the crocodile, which, you know, the crocodile, because the jaws of crocodile, you look at it, it is scary. Imagine being trapped in that. That is the samsara trap. Very difficult to disentangle ourselves from that kind of a grasp. Seems impossible. That kind of a shishya who is grasped by the crocodile in the form of this mahagraha, that too, a huge crocodile, in the form of samsara, that kind of shishya, tanmukhat, graha mukhat, jiva brahma advaita upadeshana yo mocheti. So the freedom is not real because the bondage is not real. The freedom is real in the sense that one is always free. Therefore, jiva brahma advaita upadesha alone is the way, jnana. Jnanena moksha and through such teaching one frees, mocheti is causative, nijantav, sah eva guruhu. And then there he quotes one smriti to conclude this. Baho guru vasanti shishya vittapaharakaha durlaboyam gurur devi shishya hrittapaharakaha iti smritehe. So there is a smriti where the teaching is given to Devi. He says, O Devi, there are many gurus. So guru word is used loosely. Who is a guru? So here, bahavah guravah santi, there are many gurus. Namesakes, shishya vrittapaharaka, vittapaharaka, those who take away shishya's vitta, dhana, they take away shishya's dhana, wealth. But durlavo ayam gurur devi, this guru who is rightly called as guru, gukaras chandakaro hi rukaras tejo chate, ajnana grasakam brahma guru revana samshaya, that ajnana grasaka brahma, ajnana haraka brahma, he is difficult to durlava, so dukhena labhyate. Shishya hrittapaharaka, he takes away the ajnana, ajnana which causes tapa in the hrittapa. In the hridaya, there is this ajnana granthi, avidya granthi, that is the cause for all tapa, afflictions. So shishya hrittapa haraka, he takes away the hrittapa, natu vitta, vitta. So vittapa haraka, one who takes away the vitta, whereas the other, the real guru, takes away the hrittapa. Iti smrute. Iti smrute he, that is a pramana quoted for the guru who is the right guru. Otherwise, the guru word is used very, very loosely. Shishya lakshanam. So guru lakshana has been covered here. What about shishya? Shishya lakshana. Vedanta grantha pravritti sampadakam prathama tarange yad adhikari visheshanam uktam sadhana chatushte rupam tat sampatti reva shishyase lakshanam bhavati. So the chatushte sampatti, which was talked in the first and the second chapters, prathama tarange, and then described further in this second also, adhikari visheshanam uktam in the sadhana chatushte sampatti, in the anubandha chatushteya, there was adhikari, and adhikari lakshana was given there with sadhana chatushte sampatti van. That itself is tat sampatti reva shishyase lakshanam bhavati. We missed one. There are two tippanas. Let's look at those. Janana maranatmakam bhayam. So what is this bhaya? Really, the root of all bhaya is that I will cease to be. That is the bhaya. In marana, I do not want to cease to be. I want to continue living. So janana maranatmakam bhayam. Further, Shri Vasishta, what is this for? This is for Advaita Tanmukha Jiya Brahma Advaita Upadeshena. So that Upadesha, on that there is a comment. Let me see, what is Shri Vasishta Dvividha Bhagavata Suta Samhitadi Sakala Itihasa Puranadishu Advaitameva Pratipadyate. So not only the Shruti Tatparya is Advaita, but all these Granthas which are based on Shruti are also committed to the same Tatparya. Shri Vasishta. So Vasishta, the Yoga Vasishta. Dvivida Bhagavata Suta Samhitadi Sakala Itihasa Puranadishu Adishu. So we can take everything. Every Shastra is committed towards same Advaita Tattva really. Even the Paurusheya Granthas, which are based not on one's own Buddhi, they follow the Shruti, they'll have the same Tatparya. Advaita Meva Pratipadyate. In those Granthas only Advaita is being revealed. Tatha Ashtottara Shatopanishatsu Api. So in 108 Upanishads, which are considered as authentic, because others have just creeped in, all sorts of Upanishads, Allah Upanishad. When we see Allah Upanishad in a meaningless words in even Chaukamba publication, I think 156 or 181, I don't remember the number, in that others are there. But what is authentic? The listing made in the last Upanishad. 108th Upanishad is Muktika Upanishad. So Sampradayavadis agree that at least those 108 we agree with that they are authentic. Others are lost in the Sampradaya. Some have crept in. There are under the pressure of the Mughal rule. Some have written Upanishads, kind of Upanishads, and added. So there is a lot of controversy there. But Ashtottara Shato Upanishad, those Upanishads which are listed in Muktika Upanishad, including Muktika itself, it lists as 108, it lists itself. That list is considered as authentic. In those, the first 10 is what Bhagavan Bhashyakara has commented on. Ishakena Kata Prashna Munda Mandukya Tittiri, and then the Tittiri, and then Aitareya Chandogyan Brihat Tatha. So, Brihadaranyakam Tatha. Apicha Anadigata Abadita Apurvatva Apurvatvaccha. Looks like there's a typo there. Apicha anadigata abadita apurva apurvatva cha advaitam eva shastrartha. So advaita is a shastrartha. What kind of advaita? See, all these granthas, Paurushaya granthas, may talk about other things also. Just like Shruti also talks about quite a few things. What becomes the tatparya? Tatparya, Shruti is a pramana, and so are these others, shabda pramana. That which is not known, anadigata. In fact, any pramana, anything is a pramana only when you know something through those means alone, and it reveals something that you didn't know earlier, anadigata. This is a definition. Anadigata abadita, and it should not be negated later. What is the way it is known, it remains in the same way. So anadigata and abadita, and in the case of Shruti here, anadigata abadita and apurvatva. Apurvatva is what? Apurvatva is which is not known through any other means. Not only unknown, cannot be known by any other means. That is a pramana. So it should not be known, and then it should not be negatable, and it should not be known through any other means, not knowable through any other means. That is advaita, because advaita is unknown. Nobody knows advaita unless taught by the Shruti. Only Shruti reveals advaita. No other work which is not based on Shruti reveals advaita. So the primary source is Shruti for advaita. And abadita, advaita can never be negated, whereas dvaita can be negated, swapnavata. So anadigata, unknown, abadita, and apurvatva, anyway, we have seen that it cannot be known by any other means, only Shruti reveals it. Now everything other than that, if Shruti talks about dvaita, it describes dvaita creation elaborately, it talks about many jivas, all those, for all those, Shruti is not a pramana, because I know of jivas even before the Shruti reveals it. I know that there are many people. I know the bheda between me and the creator. Even if I, let's say I don't know the creator, if they logically I can establish a creator, because nothing comes about on its own. So if there is something created, there is definitely a creator. If I see the world outside, there is a creator. If I see a person outside, I know that the person has come from his or her parents. So the parents are karana. If I see a ghata, there is ghatakara. There is kulala. A potter is there who has created that pot. Similarly, the world is there. There has to be a creator. I don't need Shruti to tell me that there is a creator. One or many is irrelevant right now. But am I that creator? If someone asks me, am I that creator, or if there are many creators, am I part of those many creators? If you ask anyone, did you create the world? No, I may have created a pot, a building, A city designed it, but did you create it? No. Nobody has a doubt. Nobody is schizophrenic enough to think that I am the creator of the world. So it's already known. Bheda is established. Jiva Jiva Bheda, Jiveshwara Bheda, Jiva Jada Bheda. Are you the world? I am not the world. Who says that I am the world? Are you one with your parents, your children? Maybe there one may say, yes, yes, I am one with my parents. I am one with my beloved. I am one with my spouse. I am one with my friends, my family. Yes, but beyond that, are you one with others? Even there, I am not really one. Nobody will say that. Figuratively, one may say, no, I love my family so much, I am one with them. But are you really one? No, nobody claims it. So Jiva Jiva Bheda is also known. Jada Jada Bheda, you know, you say your money is mine, my money is also mine. That is the Abheda there. But Bheda is known. Your money is yours, my money is mine. Your things are yours, my things are mine. Nobody thinks that Jada Jada Abheda is there. Jada Jada Bheda, Jada Jiva Bheda, Jiveshwara Bheda. All these Bhedas are known through all other Pramanas, various other Pramanas. Neither are they anadigata, but they are abadita. They are not abadita also. They will have bada, even if you hold on to it. And what our interest is apurvatva is not there in any dvaita that is talked about by Shruti. If Shruti talks about creation, multiple jivas are created, world is created, there is a Panchikarana, all the process elaborately, still Shruti is not a Pramana there. That is not the Shastrarthaha. Because I already know it. If Shruti teaches it, it is not the Pramana. So whenever you hear these Dvaita, Vishishtadvaita, Nayayika, all sorts of Aropas, all those Aropas are bogus, including Jainas and Buddhists, because for them anyway, there is no Pramana. They take the karma, theory of karma from Shruti. Buddhists and Jains agree that there is karma. Buddhists say that the Atma is, there is no nothing like Atma. Shunya, Shunyam Atma. If they say Shunyam Atma, who has karma? Shunya cannot have continuity of karma. There cannot be this continuity, pratyabhijna, in this one single life, and across lives, definitely there cannot be Shunya Atma. What kind of illogical thinking is there? Because of there is no grace of Shruti. Shruti Anugrah has to be there. Acharya Anugrah has to be there. They have divorced themselves from stolen things from Vedas and cooked up something. Dvesha. Dvesha towards Vedas. Jainas also same thing. They have the theory of karma. They have Atma which is has a size, you know, grows and shrinks. No pramana for any of that. Just some buddhi kalpita. And they have also, where did this get, they get the idea of Atma and the, there is no pramana for Atma. Particularly samsari Atma, which has a different life. You can say I am different from the body, possible logically. But you continue to be in another janma. What is the pramana? It cannot be just imagination. It has come from Shruti. So they take that and then there is no Shruti Anugraha because they give up the Shruti. So Jaina, same problem. All of these have same problem. Others, they have concluded without taking Shruti as the main Pramana. They say Shruti, as they give lip service to Shruti. Shruti also sees it. They are very selective. They don't have Shastrartha. They don't know what Shastrartha is really. Tatparya, they cannot conclude in. The Shadlinga that we saw in the Prathama Adhyaya isn't there for them. Kincha Bruhi so this is Bruha Bruhi Vriddhau. So Kincha Bruhi Vriddhau iti Dhatuhu Vriddhimachaste. What is this Bruhi Vriddhau from which Brahman is derived? So Brahman is derived from the Dhatu Bruhi Vriddhau. Vriddhi Arthe. Dhatu is Vriddhi Artha. Has Vriddhi Artha. So it talks about Vriddhi. What kind of Vriddhi? Sacha Vriddhi Atra Pratiyogi Visheshanupadanat Niratishaya Eva Vivakshita. that vriddhi is niratishaya. It does not have any limitation. Kindly switch off your video. So niratishaya eva. It has no limit. Ramchandran ji, please switch off your camera. So what happens here? This vriddhi, which is described in the dhatu patha, brahma, for as meaning for brahman, that brahmi brahma dhatu takes manin pratya, and then it's a unadi pratya, and then there is a derivation and you land on brahman. Now this brahman which is there, it is a noun substantive. It is not qualified by any adjective that can limit it. Sati tu vastvantare tena paricchedad vriddehe niratishayatvam bhajyet. So what happens is that if you have any other vastu, there is no other vastu other than Brahman which can limit it. So you don't need an adjective to limit it. How big is it? How much is the vriddhi? There is nothing in the Shruti which says how much is the vriddhi. It says that anuraniyan mahatomaya. It is bigger than the biggest, smaller than the smallest. So it takes away this very idea of limitation. So there is desha paricheda, vastu paricheda, kala paricheda. None of these are possible. Vriddhi is in all ways. It is infinite. Purnatvam. Tatacha vastvantara kruta paricheda rahitam eva brahma shabda vachyam. What is the meaning of Brahma really is that which is rahita, free from paricheda. Vastvantara kruta. Now, he is taking vastu. Deshakala is also there. What about deshakala? Deshakala yoropi vastutva. Deshakala also vastu. So, he takes a very shortcut method, you know. Laghavam. He says, why should I talk about desha and kala paricheda? Because deshakala cheda, kala, desha and kala paricheda are not needed. We don't even need to talk about them. Desha kala rupi vastutva. Vastu matrasya cha brahma swarupe adhyastatvena vastu kruta paricheda nirasena eva. Brahmani desha kala kruta paricheda niraso bodhyaha. So even if vastu paricheda is known, the desha and kala are vastu, vastava. Desha is there, vasatiti vastu. So if you say desha, is desha there, is kala there? Yes. Then it's vastu. He takes a very simple methodology. He says that I don't even need to go ahead and do the desha paricheda rahita. I don't need to establish that. Or kala paricheda shunya. It is nirasa bodhya. Desha kala kruta paricheda nirasa api bodhya. From what? Just by vastu kruta paricheda nirasa eneiva. In Brahma, there is no paricheda at all. So that is the idea here. Let's go to Mula. Go back to Mula. So Shishya Lakshana is done. We saw that it is same as the Adhikari as described in the Adhikari Visheshana Muktam. Prathama Tarange Yad Adhikari Visheshana Muktam. Tat Sampatti Reva Shishyase Lakshanam. What is that? Sadhana Chatushtaya Rupam. Guru Bhakte Phalam. What is the phala of Guru Bhakti now? So it is good to have Guru Bhakti. Ishvara apekshaya api adhikataya shraddha bhakti pranamadikam guru shishyena kartavyam. So here it is said that one should bow down to the guru more than the Ishvara, because he shows the Ishvara. Ishvara cannot be known. Ishvara swarupa, which is one's own swarupa, cannot be known unless I had a guru. Therefore I should bow down to my guru. Yato akhila shastra vitpanno api guru padesham antara swatma tattvam na janiyat. Why so? Because even if you are a pandita, know all the shastra, you know enough Sanskrit, Vyakrana, and you can study and understand, but still, even if we have the understanding of shastra at that level of Sanskrit and Vyakrana, guru upadesha mantara swatma tattvam na janiyat, you still cannot understand what is your real swarupa. नैषा तर्केण मतिरापनीय नायमात्मा प्रवचनेन लभ्यो न मेधयान बहुना श्रुतेन आचार्यवान पुरुषो वेद आचार्याध्येय विद्या विदिता साधिष्टं प्राप्त इति श्रुतेहे. He quotes many shrutis there. एषा विद्या तर्केण, विद्या इज मति, मति इज देयर बुद्धि, बुद्धि इज in the sense of this vritti, which is the understanding, jnanam, vidya ityartha, jnanam ityartha. Esha vidya matihi vidya tarkena napaneya. Just by shushka tarka, you cannot get it. Even if you have trained yourselves in every vidya there is, like, you know, there, even if we study for many lives, we cannot learn as much as Narada Muni learned. Narada Muni had so many vidyas, he listed those, we can't even pronounce all the vidyas, let alone know what those are, let alone understand what they are, let alone have those. Bahuduram. And that kind of Narada went to Sanakadi Muni and said that, he went to Sanat Kumara and said that, you know, Shokami, Shochami, Saham Shochami, Saha, Shoka, Shokam Anubhavami. So Saham Shochami, Saha means that kind of me who has this list of all these, you know, he says that Sakala Shastra with Saham Shochami, He Bhagava. So, oh Bhagavan, I really have grief and I've heard that. Tarati Shokam Atma with one who knows Atma, crosses over Atma, and that Atma Jnana cannot be through Shastra Jnana without a Guru. So Guru Upadesha Mantara, it's not possible. Na ayam Atma Pravachanena Labhyaha. Pravachana there is by Vedic chanting. If you know the best, you know the Chaturveda Pandita, still na labhya Atma. Medhaya, na medhaya, just by Medha Shakti. I have all these kanthastha and I can recall when needed. Maybe I can quote also, but ayam atma na labhya, medhaya na labhya, na bhavna shrutena. If one continues to hear shruta, Bhagavan Bhashyakara glosses over and says that this should not be misunderstood as shravana of Vedanta. Vedanta. So other than Vedanta, other than Upanishad, it won't work. Or another meaning is, it should not be Shuddha Shravana. Shuddha Shravana is a, you know, negative way of saying actually. It is a way of saying that Shravana means just hearing. One is not inquiring into it. Shravana, we have seen, it should take away Pramana Samshaya. So Pramana Samshaya, if it does not go, then it is not Shravana at all. So Bahuna Shruti, you know, that kind of Shravana will not take away, will not lead to Atma Labha. Acharya Deva Vidya Vidita Sadhishtam Prapata. Only that Vidya which has come from Acharya will lead you to success, will fructify. Other self-study does not. Self-study, it is equivalent to saying that I am a doctor. I have studied all the entire course material of Harvard Medicine School and others also maybe. By myself, I have no teacher, I don't care for a teacher, but I am a doctor. Who will go and take treatment under this doctor? Tomorrow I say that I can, you know, operate on anyone. I have self-studied and I have trained myself to be a doctor. It is as simple as that. I do not know why people think that they can study just because they know the language, be it Sanskrit, English, whatever. There are translations, I don't need Sanskrit. Oh, I know Sanskrit, I am a Vyakarana Pandita, I can study Shastras on my own. Have you been taught in the Sampradaya? No, I don't need it. What Sampradaya? But the same person being an engineer or a doctor said that, oh, he, you know, says that I have studied in that kind of a school. What school? You could have studied at home. Why did you not study at home? There, no, I mean, I need to know how to really, you know, get to that teaching. Real teaching is there only when it comes from the teaching tradition, the respective teaching tradition, be it the school of medicine or engineering. The same thing applies to Vedanta Jnana also. But somehow for Vedanta, oh, I don't need it, you know. I understand without the guru. So this is the unfortunate, you know, unfortunate hypocrisy. So Acharyavan Purusho Veda, and then Chandogya Shruti, I missed that. Says Acharyavan. Acharya asya asti iti acharyavan purusha sadhaka veda sa veda. He knows. Veda here, litlakara as well as latlakara. Both meanings are there because latlakara takes the litlakara pratyaya also. So it means that kind of a, he knows. as good as knows. Because having an acharya, sampradaya acharya, he will not go wrong. He will get that knowledge. He'll atma labha, he'll definitely get. Therefore, the Shruti says that if he has an acharya, then it is as good as knowing. Evameva arthaha vakshya vakshyamana. This should be vakshyamana. There is a typo. Evameva arthaha vakshyamana drishtantena sputikriyate. So it will be made clear through the example which will be talked about now. Tathahi vedarupa samudra guru upadesha bhave sharo bhavati. Sharasagare patitaha tajjalam pitva kevalam dukkham eva anubhavati. Yatha tatha guru upadesham vinayeva shastrantara kushalapi. Swatantrena vedartham vicharayanto guru sampradaya bhavad bheda eva sarva vedartha iti swamati vibhavanusarana nischitya bheda rupa kshara jalam eva aswadya janana marana prabandhatmaka dukkham eva avishramam anubhavanti natu mukti rupa nitya nirtishya ananda labante. So example given is the salty water of the samudra. Samudra has salty water. So ayam eva artha, this very idea is explained here. Tatha hi veda rupa samudra. The samudra, veda is sagara. It is samudra, it is so vast. And guru upadesha bhave ksharo bhavati. Just like the samudra is salty, if you do not know how to get sweet water out of the salty water. So today's day, you know, reverse osmosis. RO. So guru upadesha bhave ksharaha bhavati. It is salty. This Veda will not lead you to what is the real content. The clean water in the samudra, which the samudra hides. Ksharasagare patitaha tajjalam pitva kevalam dukkham eva anubhavati yatha. If one drinks the samudra, he says, I don't need water. There is samudra is available freely. Why do I need water? So I can go anywhere. No, do not go near the samudra where there is no sweet water. Stay where you can get the sweet water. If you tell someone, he says, oh, there is, I am on the coast. I have samudra there. I can have water, but if you take that water, it is salty. It is not drinkable water. Kshara-sagare patitaha tajjalam pitva kevalam dukkham eva anubhavati yatha. If one drinks that water, he will have dukkha. Tatha guru upadesham vinayeva shastrantara kushalapi svatantrene vedartham vicharayantaha guru sampradaya bhava bheda eva sarva vedartha iti. So what is the tatpari of the Shruti? Bheda. This fellow with his own buddhi lands on that. Even these others who have created the sampradaya divorce from Advaita later, even after Bhagavan Bhashyakara spent so much of time and effort and analyzed everything, showed the tatpariya, refuted every possible dvaita, still similar mix-up of all those flavors of those very dvaitins, very dvaita philosophies which were refuted, they have mixed up and come up and repackaged as dvaita, vishishta dvaita, bheda, bheda, all sorts of philosophies, calling themselves as Vedanta also. How did they come about? They came about because they divorced from the Sampradaya. They thought about themselves and called themselves as Sampradayas. They may also claim that ours is from, you know, Narayana and all that, but still, they have divorced from the Advaita Sampradaya, which has been Anadi Sampradaya, and then they established it using their own Shastra Jnana independently. Therefore, what will happen? They will Shastrantara Kushalapi, even if they know other Shastras, what they do is that I know Padma Purana, I know Bhagavata, and then they don't know Bhagavata and Padma Purana also. They are selective because Bhagavata can be shown to be having Tatparena Dvaita. Still, Swatantrena Vedartham Vicharanta, they independently analyze Veda without understanding the Tatparya of the Shruti, this Anadigata, Abadita, Apurvatva. They don't know these. They don't apply these, and thereby Swatantrena Vedartham Vicharanta Guru Sampradaya Bhavad, because of not having the tradition anadi sampradaya, they may claim it, they may rebuild the sampradaya because they have to skip who was the acharya. Look at the acharyas of these very so-called institutions which are anadi. You look at their first acharya. Let's not name them, we all know, but if you look at them, who did they study under? They studied under Advaita Acharyas. So how is it that they divorced from Advaita and created another sampradaya? They created all that has to be Swatantrena. It is not with the teacher. They felt bad. They thought that their teacher, what he is teaching is blasphemy for whatever reasons. Guru Sampradaya Bhavad Bhedeva Sarva Vedartha Iti Swamati Vibhavanusarena. So they have preconcluded notions what the Shastra should teach, what the Acharya should teach, and thereby they say whatever Acharya teaches, whatever Shruti says, which is not acceptable to me, I'll reinterpret those or discard them as Arthavada, and then Nishchitya Bheda Rupas Kshara Jalam Meva Aswadya. Because Advaita is the sweetness, the sweet water is Advaita in Vedartha, in Vedas, Veda Vedanta. But these people get Dvaita, which is Kshara Jalam. You have already have Dvaita. You don't need Shruti to tell you that. The entire struggle in this world is due to Dvaita. There are debates, there are fights because of the other. And then that is Kshara Jalam. You already had Samudra, and then you go to sweet water source also, and then you give up that. You say that I am okay with Samudra. What will happen? Bheda Rupa Kshara Jalam Eva Aswade Janana Marana Prabandatmaka Dukkham Eva Avishramam Anubhavanti Avishramam. So that kind of a, you know, which will never come to an end. You keep to Bheda, it will never come to end. If you keep on drinking the Kshara Jala in the Samudra, thinking that someday it will turn sweet, it will never turn sweet. Natu mukti rupa nitya nirtisha ananda lavante. They do not attain the ananda. Bhakti also what? Advaita bhakti. If we say bhakti, it will be advaita bhakti. Mukti rupa nitya nirtisha ananda. That ananda which cannot be transgressed by any bhakti also of yours, which is dvaita bhakti, will not give you that ananda, which is advaita ananda, which is your own swarupa. Because what you are tasting in the dvaita bhakti also is advaita bhakti, a part of it. And this topic, the example needs to be concluded. Jiva Brahmaikya Upadeshta Eva Guru Riti Guru Lakshanam Nirupitam. I missed something. No, okay. Sorry. Let me just reduce the font size and go back. So that, yeah, this is 68 and then 69 is, the page number is 69 here. Okay. So let me quickly go through this. The last part of this point here. Jiva Brahmaikya Upadeshta Eva Guru Riti Guru Lakshanam Nirupitam. This is the Guru Lakshana is what? One who teaches the Aikya between Jiva and Brahma. Tadrushad akhanda brahmatmaikatva vidaha sadguroho mukhadye vedanta vicharam kuruvanti te devamrutat api adhikam niratishayam brahmanandam anubhavanti. So it was said earlier, it just before this line, and gathering from who is the guru, he is putting that together, those two points together. Tadrushad akhanda brahmatmaikatva vidaha. One who knows from that guru, Sadguru Mukhad, from the teaching of the guru, which kind of a guru? Who knows this Akhanda Brahmatma Tattva, Brahmatmaikatva. He knows that Brahma as one's own Swarupa. Vedanta Vicharam Ye Kuruvanti. Those who continue Vedanta Vichara, Te Devamrutad Api Adhikam Niratishem Brahmanandam Anubhavanti. So they get the Ananda which is not comparable to any of these. Devas, etc. Amruta. None of those. The Amruta that the Devas had after the Samudra Manthana, whichever Amruta came, that led to some Ananda. this ananda is that led to a adhika, lot of huge amount of ananda definitely, because devas already have more ananda and that ananda will continue because amruta, because of partaking amruta, the ananda life has been extended now. Therefore, they have a lot of ananda compared to them also. Niratishayam brahmanandam anubhavanti ke ye vedanta vicharam kurvanti guru mukhat prapya. So getting the brahmajnana from the guru yatha swabhavata ksharam. Now he is showing that in the example that he has used, yatha swabhavata ksharam samudra jalam patrena grihitva pitan chet tada ksharam eva bhavati. If one picks up the samudra jala in a patra, in a vessel, and drinks that, it will be salty. However, tadeva samudra jalam meghairakrushya vrishtam sat pitam ched atimaduram bhavati. However, if it is picked up from the natural aro, what is natural aro? The evaporation, and then meghai, through the clouds, if it is vrishtam sat, if it comes down in the form of rains. What is rainwater? Rainwater is the purest water. But what is the source? It has come from the same samudra. It has been picked up from the samudra and it has been rained by the clouds. Tadeva samudra jalam, kshaaram jalam, meghairakrushya vrishtam sat peetam ched atimaduram bhavati. But that itself is extremely sweet when it pours down as rain. Tatha vedartho api svatantrena guru sampradayam vina vicharitas ched janana marana ched, there is an extra ja here, I think, vicharitas ched janana marana dukkha hetur bhavati. However, similarly, in the exemplified, if swatantrena guru sampradayam vina, if one studies this vedartha oneself, one lands oneself in what? Janana marana dukkha. It becomes the cause of dukkha, because dukkha is already there, it continues as this vedartha. Without the Guru Sampradaya, will Swatantrena will lead to erroneous conclusions. It will not give Sakshatkara and then it will become the Hetu for Dukkha to continue. Saeva Advaita Brahmatma Aparokshanu Bhavi Sri Sadguru Mukhadava Avapyate Chet Nitya Nirtishaya Aparoksha Akhandananda Swarupa Atma Arigamaya Bhavati. And on the other hand, if that very Vedartha is known through Guru Sampradaya, Advaita Brahmatma Aparoksha Anubhava, Anubhavi, one who has that Anubhava, Aparoksha Anubhava, Sakshatkara, Shri Sadguru Mukhad Avapyate Chet, if it is attained through that Sadguru, then Nitya Niriteshaya Aparoksha Khandananda Swarupatmaka Adhigamaya Bhavati. It will be leading to Adhigama. Sakshatkaraya bhavatityartha tasmad gurum mukhadeva vedartho grahyo vaidikena. Therefore, one should get this vedartha, Vedanta teaching from the guru that is established. Next, we'll see brahmajnyad gurureva vedartho grahyaha. It is concluded. We'll look at this in the next part. Sarva vedant siddhanta ucharam tam ucharam. Okay, this is Viveka Chudamani that came to mind. Okay. Sukham nityam saprakasham. व्यापकन्नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर दुर्ग्यत्वे निर्मलं पारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम महः तदेव अहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चितावतिः तत्सत्. के आउट ऑफ टाइम टुडे, इफ देयर आर क्वेश्चंस आई विल टेक इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट और ऑन व्हाट्सएप. नमस्ते.
हरि ओम.